The polls have so often been Julia Gillard's enemy. Today, they came to her rescue. Political editor Hugh Rimmerton has more on this story for us tonight. And Hugh, a strong lift for Labor in News poll. So has that killed off any talk of a leadership challenge?
Well, Sandra, it certainly has for now. When it comes to leadership, the polls giveth and the polls taketh away. And right now, the polls have given to Julia Gillard in a most critical time, just as there were deep murmurings about her capacity to lead Labor to anything other than a deep defeat come September. She has been given this extra lifeline today, and she looked very pleased.
Dark omens over Parliament this morning, but all cheers for the Prime Minister, toasting Canberra's centenary and a lifeline from the polls. From 10 points adrift to just 4 points behind, back in the contest.
I hope that what we now get is a greater focus on what the opposition actually stands for.
On a warm morning, the festivities were too much for some, but the PM's body language said it all. News poll puts her back in front as preferred Prime Minister. She has breathing space from leadership talk. Even one opposition MP says she deserves more respect.
I believe we need to lay off the Prime Minister and the personal attacks. I think it's not Australian to continue to comment in a vicious and personal manner.
Tony Abbott, not so sure.
The only attacks on the Prime Minister at this point in time are coming from her own colleagues.
Certainly no new respect at question time, either from the opposition...
How can this answer be in the least bit relevant?
..or from the public gallery.
That word is not acceptable from anybody in this place.
Including today, there are just 18 sitting days left before the election. That's the cue for a flurry of legislation as the government seeks to close off unfinished business and set itself up for the vote.
One pledge today to prevent any cuts to media diversity.
We intend to prosecute this case. We believe it is necessary.
Another to get new federal powers over coal seam gas projects.
I think those involved in agriculture will be very pleased.
Labor taking on media barons and the resource sector. Right on message.
However it goes between here and September, the real economic issues they're going to face whichever party wins power were spelled out again today by Treasurer Wayne Swan. He says that revenue for the government has dropped by $6 billion since the very end of last year. That is a lot of money that can't be spent. It's a lot of money that can't be spent by either side on promises to win votes, Sandra.
OK, Hugh Rimmerton, thank you.